But first, it's Gordo's Corner, brought to us by CrestCars.com.
Thank you so much, Miller Man. Well, before we get to the truth that the NFL does not want you to know, and as they've been hiding this from you purposefully, we have breaking news, gentlemen.
We do.
Hit the sounder, Expo. People Magazine is reporting that after 39 years of marriage, a very famous couple is breaking up.
Okay, let me think. 39 years?
Mm-hmm. Everyone thought that love would keep them together, but apparently...
I saw this.
Captain and Tinnelle?
Yeah, I saw
apparently
that.
Captain and Tinnelle have decided to call it quits after 39 years.
I was going to guess Bayquick.
All right, let me decipher this. Beyonce and... No? Bayquick.
Kevin Bacon and Kira Sedgwick.
Wow.
No one's ever called them that.
Never heard that before. Catherine Antoinette Tinnelle. Tony Tinnelle. Filed for divorce from Captain Daryl Dragoon. Daryl Dragon in Arizona. The Cap, who is 71 years of age, seemed blindsided by the breakup. He said, I don't know why she filed. I got to figure it out for myself first.
Hmm. That's too bad. We all liked them, didn't we?
Yeah.
Now, they met in 1972 when Tony Tinnelle was the co-writer for a musical and the captain was the keyboardist for the Beach Boys. And she toured with the band for about a year as an additional keyboardist. So they both played keyboards for the Beach Boys. And then they started performing together at a restaurant where they were discovered by Neil Sedaka. Sedaka? Sedaka?
Sedaka.
They married in 1974. They hit number one on the Billboard chart the next year with their cover of this song you're listening to right here, Love Will Keep Us Together. Won a Grammy for Record of the Year. Can you name their other hits?
Muskrat Love.
Mm-hmm.
Staying Alive?
No. Love Theme from Jaws?
God, that almost beat me when she started with that.
Man, I was into this song as a kid.
Really?
Yep.
Yep, I was too. Wasn't there a bit that he didn't speak?
No, it's Penn and Teller.
No, it was. He never... They'd get on some...
How did that work? They were on a variety show together.
He rarely talked on that.
Yeah.
I thought he did. He had to. He's in skits.
I think his bit was that
like
he
Harpo.
Never spoke.
Yeah.
Now, did you say 39 years?
Yes.
At some point, don't you just decide you're going to ride it out now? You're into your 70s?
Why? If you know it's over, why you want to say that you're going to give the remaining years to it? Why is the music?
Rich? Yeah, Rich.
Just avoid all the mess.
What's the mess?
Divorce?
Yeah, but sometimes the marriage may be more of a mess than the divorce.
You got to split up the Captain and Tinnelle empire.
Is there really an empire anymore?
This song was ridiculous.
That's a good question.
So does she get half his hats? Those ridiculous, whatever those hats were. What do you call that
sailor,
kind of hat? Sailor hat?
Captain hat. Yeah, captain hat, I guess. He's the captain.
Was he a captain?
I'm a captain.
All right, so this is Muskrat Love?
Mm-hmm. Pretty song, but ridiculous lyrics.
What? I don't understand it. I guess I never listened to the lyrics. What is Muskrat Love?
Muskrat Sally and Muskrat Sam and...
What?
That was Mustang having... Sally.
No. At the beginning, she said
thinking
her
of
name.
Polk Salad Annie.
I guess she was watching two muskrats one day and she was bored. I don't know.
Doing turn it up. Chewing on cheese. Sam says Susie,
honey, would you please be my missus? Sam and Susie.
What the hell is this song about?
Number one hit, too, right? Fancy, rubbing her toes, muzzle to
muzzle now. Anything goes as they wriggle. It's like a joke song that somebody would write. But Doctor Who is just beaming in. Yeah, they had Muskrat Love, and they also had Do That to Me One More Time.
Do That to Me One More Time.
Not a bad song.
I swear there's been other songs of that tune.
Yeah, I know. I always got that song.
You were asking if they had an empire. They do still, kind of, yeah. According to Celebrity Net Worth.
Hold on a second, Craig. Chuck Kelly is joining us now.
According to Celebrity Net Worth, Tony Tinnelle worth $9 million. So...
Really?
Yeah.
So like she must have inherited some money.
No, they probably made a lot of money in the 70s. They must have made a ton.
Is she related to Vince Tinnelle?
Who's that?
That's Vince Neil.
No. Well, I don't know.
No, they're not related.
Now, this is about backside stuff, right?
I don't know about that. You wish.
What? Why would I wish that?
Bottom.
Ugh. This is gross.
Why don't we sing to each other at ticket stock?
What is this about?
Let's do that again. It was a nice night. Let's do it again.
Jason Garrett saying it's about the bottom. I know it's not about that because no woman would say this. Yeah, so that is the sad news. They are divorcing.
That is sad. I hate to hear that.
So what happens to all these songs now?
Well, it'll be played on KVIL, I guess.
Why do you want to rag on KVIL?
I'm not. I said it's a good song. Getting the dog.
So, for instance, this song, she was the writer, he was the producer.
Really and truly? Do you know this, or are you guessing?
Yeah, no, I'm looking this up.
Okay.
So, I guess they had co-ownership of it?
Mm-hmm.
Or just the writer?
A married
the writer
couple,
own
I bet
it.
They split it.
The writer. Well, that's the other thing. I don't know where they... I guess they lived in Arizona. And if that's a community property state, then it doesn't matter who wrote it, right?
And if they split it just down the middle, that means she gets Do That to Me and he gets One More Time? How does that work?
Yeah, she can't sing the whole chorus.
Right.
Oh, hold on a second. Zamfir has entered the mix. They have no children. Well, that's a shame. They may have been right about to have kids.
Doubt it.
All right, the truth that the NFL... Oh, so we need to tell... J.R. Captain and Tinnelle's
not dead.
Marriage!
They're still alive.
All
right, the truth that the NFL has been keeping from you. Now, Fernando, this stuff sounds so fantastic. This better be correct.
Fernandez has
what's,
more.
What's so fantastic?
You handed me this.
His salary? That's
well,
not fantastic.
But the other stuff, too. I didn't hear any of this other stuff about the NFL.
This what? Guy's a pretty reputable reporter.
All right. Do you know how much Roger Goodell makes? The
it's
NFL
absurd. It's
commish.
Like $17 million or $19 mm-hmm. million a year or something like that.
Close.
$29.5 million.
Wow, it's up to 29 now?
Jeez.
And did you know this? That the NFL... is a 501c6 organization. It is a not-for-profit organization.
It is?
Yes.
I didn't know that. How is that possible?
Well, in order to have this status, the NFL has to be run as a charitable foundation. And in 2012, they gave away millions of dollars.
How many millions?
$2.3 million.
Oh, my gosh.
That's
generated how
all?
Many billion?
We've done the story on that pinkware in October.
Yeah. About what if
they don't give away anything from that.
And by the way, $2.1 million of the $2.3 million that they gave away went to the charity known as the NFL Hall of Fame.
Holy cow.
So that leaves $200,000 that went to charities that... went to charities.
Did they interview Roger Goodell about this, and what does he say?
No, he's not quoted in the story.
Wow.
It says here that Goodell's salary is one-tenth of what the NFL claimed in total assets in 2012. They claim in assets $255 million.
All right.
So that means they made charitable donations equaling one 100th of their annual income.
When in reality, the league is worth billions and billions and billions, not 250 million. So imagine the percentage of, I don't know, what's the league worth?
Oh my gosh.
If the Cowboys are worth a billion, now right. I get that there are individual owners of these teams.
And the league doesn't own the franchises, but they own the franchise that is the NFL.
Right. They claimed revenue of $255 million, which was up from 2011. This, I'm giving you the 2012 numbers, was $255 mm-hmm. million, which is the latest one that was available here. That's up from $240 million in 2011. So they gained $15 million between 11 and 12. They have assets. Now, this says they have assets of over $822 million. Now, how do you figure that?
So I guess they're talking about...
when they just claimed that they only had $255 million in 2012. Mm.
So what are they talking about? Actual NFL property? When they talk about their assets or what they're worth? NFL films or the NFL network? Or...
I don't know. This says under grants, meaning donations to other nonprofit organizations, the NFL did increase the number from just over 900,000 to 2.3 million between years. So in 2011, they only gave $900,000 to charity. Wow. And then they increased it to 2.3 million in 2012, which is unbelievable. And their total salaries between those 2 years increased by 27 million to a total of 107 million. And get this, in 2012, the NFL claims that it finished the year in the red, negative $316 million.
No way.
They've got the best at cooking the
talking
books.
About, yeah, talking about cooking books.
Have you ever heard of cooked books like this?
Not really.
And the guy who's running a business that has lost $316 million gets paid $30 million a year. Mm.
This is why we have labor problems every 6 years.
Mm-hmm. Now, if they weren't a not-for-profit organization, if the NFL weren't a charity, which this is news to me that they are, Goodell would come in around number 28 of the highest-paid CEOs in 2012. He made more than the head of FedEx, the head of AT&T, the head of Heinz, the head of Ford Motors, the head of Goldman Sachs. He even made more than Rupert Murdoch.
Yeah. That is what CEOs make.
You know, we're going to get to the bottom of this next week in New York when we're at the Super Bowl. We are going to talk to Roger Goodell about this or some high up in the NFL front office.
Yes. Yeah. It's our duty.
It is our duty.
We were hanging out with him on Super Bowl Sunday just a few years ago.
You were. So there you go.
All right, Gordo, thank
you. Support your local charity this Super Bowl season.
Thank you for those shocking numbers. That's the corner.